Hello friends, this video on photosynthesis in higher plants, part 2, is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Some of the very, very early experiments of Priestley were something like this. Very simple experiments, but they gave valuable information. So let us look at one of the most early experiments of Priestley. So in his first experiment, what he did was, he took a bell jar and he placed a candle which was already lit and a mouse inside the bell jar. Now all of you know what is a bell jar. It is in the shape of a bell, but it is a closed jar. So this is how it looks like. Now he placed this candle and the mouse inside the bell jar, and now he didn't do anything else. He was just observing that what happens to the mouse and to the candle if they are kept inside a bell jar, which is like isolated from the outside environment. So there is no exchange of gases which is taking place in between the bell jar and the external environment. So inside it is all closed. And what he observed? He observed that the mouse suffocated in the closed space and the mouse died. So inside that closed space, it suffocated and died. What happened to the candle? The burning candle also got extinguished. So the candle got extinguished, the mouse died. So that was his observation. So now he started thinking, what was actually happening inside? Why did the mouse suffocate? Because mouse is a living organism and it needs oxygen. Right? So it needs to breathe in oxygen. So now when the space was closed, it proved that the mouse used up all the available oxygen inside the bell jar. When all oxygen was used up, there was no more available to it, and therefore it started to suffocate and it finally died. Similarly with the candle. Now a candle, in order to burn, it needs oxygen for combustion. Now, it used up whatever was available and after that, it got extinguished. So, his conclusion was that the mouse or the candle damaged the air. When you say damaged the air, he basically meant to say that it used up all the oxygen which was present inside the bell jar. So, now he again repeated the same experiment with a small change in it. And to his surprise, the observation was very much different. So what did he do? In his second set of experiments, he took the same setup. It's the same mouse and a mouse and a candle inside the bell jar. But this time, he had put a plant also inside it. So the same arrangement, just that now you have an additional plant inside it. And now what did he observe? He observed that the mouse survived in the closed space as well as the burning candle continued to burn. So he was quite surprised that what magic did the plant do? Now it is very obvious that last time the mouse as well as the candle, both of them died or it got extinguished because of the lack of oxygen. So then it must be that the plant is actually compensating for the lost oxygen. So whatever oxygen is taken in by the mouse or the candle is getting compensated or is getting supplied by the plants. And that is why the mouse as well as the candle is getting the oxygen that they need to continue to burn or to continue to live. So his conclusion was, the plants restore the air used up by mouse and candle. Now at that time, see, everywhere he has used, the conclusion, he has used the term air. Why? Because oxygen, carbon dioxide, all those things, everything was not discovered at that time. In fact, Priestley was the one who discovered oxygen. During the course of his experiments, while performing all these experiments, he discovered oxygen. So what he meant was, plants exchange gases. That means plants give out oxygen. So this is how one information was received, that green plants or plants give out oxygen or they release oxygen, and this oxygen is utilized by other animals. So the conclusion, final conclusion, was that plants give out oxygen. So this was one conclusion. Now, as we talk about each experiment, we will try to relate it to the current process of photosynthesis, which we know now. Then only we'll be able to understand how each of these experiments added together to the current process of photosynthesis. Now here you see it concluded that plants give out oxygen. Now if you look at the process of photosynthesis, what do you see? During the process of photosynthesis, plants take in carbon dioxide, water, in presence of sunlight, they give out glucose plus oxygen. So oxygen is a product during the process of photosynthesis. So this experiment also told that plants give out oxygen. So oxygen is a product from the plant. Now there was another experiment, or the next experiment was performed by a scientist named Ingenhaus. So what did he do? He wanted to know more about how and where plants release oxygen. Now this fact was known, that plants release oxygen, from Priestley's experiment, but from which part of the plant oxygen is released, that was not known. So Ingenhaus was interested to know that under what conditions and from which part of the plants oxygen is released. So what did he do? He took a plant and kept it in sunlight. Again, he took the same plant and kept it in dark, maybe at night when there was no sunlight. And what did he observe in both the scenarios? He observed that in presence of sunlight, there were small droplets were observed on the green parts of the plant. Since his observation was that small bubbles were formed only on the green parts in presence of sunlight, and these bubbles were not formed in case of dark. So when there was no sunlight, there were no bubbles. When there was sunlight, there were bubbles. And these bubbles were formed only on the green parts. So that was another thing to be noted, that it was not present everywhere. For example, it was not there on the roots. It was only there on the leaves, mostly on the leaves because they were primarily green. And also on other green parts, like the green portion of the stem. So what were these bubbles? So he did further research on those bubbles, that what were those bubbles, and what did he find out? Those bubbles were nothing but oxygen. So we'll see that. So his conclusion was that it is only the green parts that release oxygen in plants. So those bubbles which we saw was nothing but oxygen. So He observed that in presence of sunlight, oxygen is getting released. In absence of sunlight, it is not getting released. Also, oxygen is getting released only from the green parts of the plant and not from the non-green parts. So these were the two things which were the output of this experiment, that it is only the green parts that release oxygen in plants, and oxygen is released only in presence of sunlight. So sunlight is an important factor to release oxygen, and also the green part of the plant is an important factor. So in the process of photosynthesis also, you see that the process takes place in presence of sunlight, it releases oxygen, and also it happens only in case of green plants. Now there were scientists who further experimented to understand what special was there in the green parts that only they could release oxygen. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.